everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. A new tutorial how to make this flower square in 4 different colors. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Well, let's get started. What do we need for this flower square? 4 different colors of yarn, and for my choice of yarn I need a crochet hook of 3.5 mm, a scissor and a needle. My first color is yellow and we make a magic circle on the hook. Then we start to make a chain 2, counts for a first half double crochet. Now here in the magic circle make 11 half double crochets. Yarn over, in the magic circle grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 3 loops on the hook. That's 1. Yarn over, back in that same magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through. That's 2, 11 in total. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. With your first chain 2 here in the beginning, we have now 12 half double crochets in the magic circle. Now pull on that short tail and then the ring is closing. And then here on the top of your first half double crochet, on the top of the chain 2, so 1, 2, in that stitch go in and make a slip stitch. Now close that ring. Now we can cut off the yarn. Open that stitch and with a needle you make a little knot here on the back of your work and weave both tails in. We start on color number 2 and that's for me a dark purple color and we make a slip knot on the hook. And now we make a slip stitch in a stitch of that circle here on the top of a half double crochet here on the through a V-stitch. Grab your yarn, pull through and then pull through. Make a chain 3, 2 and 3 and now into the next stitch make 3 trebles. Yarn twice over the hook, then enter your hook in the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over and pull for two. Yarn twice over the hook, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over and pull for two. And one more time, twice over the hook, back into that same stitch and make one treble. And chain three. Enter your hook into the next stitch and make one slip stitch. And this is our first flower petal. We repeat this petal three more times. The next repeat. Enter your hook into the next stitch. Make one slip stitch. Then make a chain three. Into the next stitch. Three treble stitches. That's one. Back into that same stitch. Two. Back into that same stitch. Three. And chain three. And now enter your hook into the next stitch to make one slip stitch. Two petals done, two more petals to go. Make your two more petals and then I'll see you back here in the beginning. I'm all the way around, four petals, and now you're on the top of the first slip stitch here. You make a new slip stitch. So go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. Round three with a new color, and that's for me a light purple color. Make a slip knot on the hook. And then we make between two flower petals, between the two slip stitches, on the top of the second slip stitch, we make a new slip stitch. Let's go in with your hook here into the middle of these two stitches, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Make a chain three. So one, two and three. Now we make a double crochet here on the top of that chain three for the first treble, that stitch, chain stitch number three here in that stitch. Make one double. So yarn over. And the hook in that third chain stitch and make one double crochet. So yarn over, pull for two, yarn over and pull for two. Make one chain. Back into that same stitch with a treble. Yarn twice over the hook, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over and pull for two. Make one chain. Now into the top of the first treble of that group of three here, you make a double treble. Yarn three times over the hook. So one, two and three. Now you're on the top of that first treble. Go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. Again, a double treble back into that same stitch. So one, two, three times yarn over the hook, back into that same stitch and make a double treble. That's one, two, three and four times pull for two loops. Now make a chain into the next treble. That's the second treble of that group of three. We make three times a double treble into that same stitch. Yarn three times over the hook. Enter hook in the next stitch. Make one double treble. Chain three. 3 times over the hook, back into that same stitch, make a second double treble. And a third double treble, back into that same stitch. Make a chain. Now into the next stitch, and that's the third treble stitch of that group of three, we make 2 double trebles. Yarn 3 times over the hook, enter hook into the next stitch. Make 1 double treble and 2 double trebles. Back into that same stitch. Make a chain. Now make a treble into the top of the first chain stitch of that 3. Yarn twice over the hook into that next stitch. It's on the top of the chain 3. Make 1 chain and a double crochet back into that same chain stitch. Make a chain 3 and make a slip stitch between the 2 slip stitches here, between the next 2 flower petals. Make 1 slip stitch like this. And now we have to repeat all these stitches 3 more times, and you start here with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and make then a double crochet here on the top of that chain 3. This is your first stitch here. Repeat all these stitches all the way around 3 more times, and then close with a slip stitch here on the top of the first slip stitch. Color number 4 is for me a light brown color. Make a slip knot on the hook. And we start with a standing 2 double crochet together. And that 2 stitches we make here on the top of the treble here for the double crochet. And after that treble, after the next double crochet. This stitch and this stitch here. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over. Now enter your hook on the petal here, on the top of the treble. Here's the double crochet and here's the treble. Go in that stitch, here under through that V stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up. Now yarn over and pull through 2. Now make that double crochet not complete. We yarn over. Now enter your hook into the next treble of the next flower petal. Here's the chain 3. Then we have here that double crochet, and this is the first treble. On the top, under through that V-stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2. And now we have 3 loops on the hook. We work those stitches together. Yarn over and work all these stitches together in one go, like this. Now make a chain 5. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now here on the top of the second double treble of that group of 3 that we make in the same stitch out here. Here they are. Then we have here a group of 2 double trebles, and then the next group is 3 double trebles. And then on the top of the second double treble, we make 2 double crochets together in that stitch. Yarn over and the hook in that second double treble. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for two. Yarn over, back in that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over and pull for three. Make a chain two. Now back in that same stitch, we make two double trebles together. Yarn over twice, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. Now we have two loops on the hook. Yarn over twice, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over and pull for two. Now we have three loops on the hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops in one go. Make a chain two. Now back into that same stitch we make a two double crochet together. Yarn over, back in that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Three loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the three loops in one go. This is a corner here. This is a straight side and this is our first corner. Make and chain five. It's one, two, three, four and five. And now we work all these stitches what we do here three more times. On the top of the first treble for that double crochet, we work the first double crochet of the two double crochets together. The second double crochet that we work together is here on the top of the next treble stitch after that double crochet. Yarn over, enter your hook in that treble for the double. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for two. Yarn over. Here's the chain three, the double crochet, and this is the first treble on that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over, and pull for three. This is the same stitch than that first stitch here. Make a chain five. One, two, three, four, five. Now we search that group of the three double trebles here in the middle. And then, oh my goodness, that was an airplane. I'm sorry, we can further now. On the top of that second double treble, we make the first leaf of two double crochet together. Yarn over, enter your hook in that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. That was a lot of noise. Yarn over, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Yarn over and pull through three loops. Make a chain two. Now back in that same stitch we make two trebles together. Yarn over twice, back into that same stitch. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Till you have two loops on the hook. Yarn over twice, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over. Pull for two. Three loops on the hook, yarn over, pull for three. Make a chain two, back into that same stitch, make two double crochet together. That's one, back in that same stitch, two, three loops on the hook, yarn over and pull for three. Now make a chain five. And then we start all over again. We make two double crochets together here on the top of the next two trebles. Work like this all the way around and then we close here with a slip stitch on the top of the first stitch. I made here my last corner, the chain 5, and then we close on the top of the first 2 double crochets together, that's standing 2 double crochets to carry on the top with a slip stitch. The next round, you start with a chain, count not for a stitch. Go back into that same stitch and make one single crochet. Now you're in that chain 5 space, make 5 single crochets around that chain 5. Into that space, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 single crochets. Now on the top of the next cluster of 2 double crochets, yeah, make also 1 single crochet. Then in that chain 2 space, 2 single crochets in that space. 1 and 2. Now we have to make a corner here on the top of the 2 trebles together. Here in this stitch here, make a corner of 3 single crochets all in that same stitch. That's 1, 2, and 3 for a corner. In that chain 2 space, 2 single crochets in that space, 1 and 2. On the top of the next cluster of 2 double crochets together, 1 single crochet. In the next space of the 5 chain stitches, make 5 single crochets in that space. And then on the stitch of the 2 double crochets together, 1 single crochet. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Into the next 5 chain space, make 5 single crochets. On the top of the cluster of 2 double crochets together, 1 single crochet. In the space of the 2 chain stitches, 2 single crochets. And then we have to make a second corner. On the top of the next 2 trebles together, 3 single crochets in that stitch. Between the 2 clusters, in that chain 2, 2 single crochets. And on the top of the next cluster of 2 double crochets together, 1 single crochet. Work like this all the way around and close with a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet. I'm all the way around, make a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet. And that's here on the top of the 2 double crochets together, that first stitch. It's not on the top of that chain 1, counts for nothing, but this first single crochet here. The final round with the same color, we begin with a chain 2. Counts for nothing, it's only to high up a stitch. We make in that same stitch where we make that slip stitch in the previous round, a half double crochet. It's yarn over, and to hook in that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull through 3 loops on the hook. We do this in every stitch on the straight side. in every stitch 1/2 double crochet till we get in the corner. So every stitch 1/2 double crochet. I'm almost in the corner. And now we have to search that corner stitch. We have in the corner 3 single crochets, and then in the second single crochet, there's this stitch here. In that middle stitch, we have to make 3 half double crochets in that same stitch. This is the center stitch of the group of 3 single crochets. In that stitch, 1, back in that same stitch, 2, back in that same stitch, 3 half double crochets for a new corner. And then we have to make in every stitch in a straight side 1 half double crochet. This is the way how you work all the way around. In every stitch 1/2 double crochet, and in every corner stitch, the second single crochet, you worked 3 double crochets, 3 half double crochets in that corner all the way around. In the beginning, I'll show you how we close with an invisible join. I'm all the way around, make my last half double crochet. Now we cut the yarn, not short, a little bit longer, and now we make an invisible join in the beginning. We open up that stitch, pull that hook all the way up, all the way up like this, and then with a needle we make an invisible join, and we skip always the first stitch. Here's your chain 2, counts for nothing. This is your first half double crochet. We skip that first half double crochet. We go to the next stitch. On the second half double crochet, on the top, under through that V stitch. On the front to the back, then pull through. Now you go to the last half double crochet that you made in this round. Then on the top you see also that little V. Into the middle of that V, go in with your needle and then pull through, and this is the invisible join. Now on the back I make a little knot, go on through one little thread here, pull through, not too tight, you want to see that invisible join here on the top. You go for a second time on through that same little piece of thread. Now you work a little loop, pull through, not all the way through, but we have here a little loop now. You go with the needle into the loop and then pull. Now you have here a little knot on the back. Now weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. You see not that needle on the front. Weave both tails in and then be done. And the flower square is complete. I hope this was a useful tutorial for you. Lots of fun to create your own flower square. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!